Good morning. Would the audience please remain standing for the invocation to be given by Chaplain Ron Capico? Gentlemen, please join me in removing our caps during prayer.
Join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we are especially mindful in these days that even as Jesus spoke upon the mountain, that it rains upon the just and the unjust alike, in these days, nations and homes and villages have been leveled by typhoons and tornadoes that have come upon the just and the unjust. Communities and lives that have been blown away by winds that have come upon the just and the unjust. Towns and businesses and churches that have been crushed by winds that have come upon the just and the unjust alike, all of which makes the complicated issues of our lives maybe not that bad. It's a matter of perspective, making Jesus Christ the perspective for learning far more than just a good idea to be etched upon a clock tower, but even more so to be etched upon the tablets of our hearts. Father, we gather together this day in the name of Jesus to honor these whom you have given eyes to see and ears to hear in a world filled with people, as Jeremiah says, who chase after empty things and are becoming empty. A world in which people, as Jeremiah also says, walk backward and not forward and don't even know it. You send these forth not just as critical participants in the contemporary world, but as beacons on a hill, saying as Paul, follow me as I follow Christ, being the hands and feet of the Savior for those who are being leveled and washed away and flooded by life. Oh God, even as we honor these for having succeeded in the serious study of the liberal arts, find them honoring you with a liberal joy and expressing the art of lives lived so as not to be served, but to serve. Now, just as you have asked, that whatever we do, to do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, we dedicate this ceremony, these graduates, and all that is said and done to your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated.
On behalf of the Spring Arbor University Board of Trustees, administration, faculty, and staff of Spring Arbor University, it is truly my sincere pleasure to welcome the parents, the family, the friends of the class of 2013, and then a very special welcome to all of the graduates of 2013. Congratulations. And at this time, I do want to recognize members of the Spring Arbor University Board of Trustees. If you could stand, we could recognize you. Thank you for your service. Our President's Cabinet, deans and faculty that are present with us today, if you could please stand and be recognized as well. Thank you for the service and dedication to these students and allowing them to complete such a wonderful, wonderful achievement. But let me say to you today, while this is the culmination of many years of preparation, and definitely congratulations are in order to each of you, this is not a conclusion. Instead, this is a commissioning. To now use what you have been given. Use the investment of the faculty, the staff, fellow students, the dedication and sacrifice of parents and family and friends and loved ones who have rallied around you and allowed you to accomplish this wonderful, wonderful thing that we're celebrating today. But use this now as a time to go and make a difference in this world. Use this as an opportunity to earn the right to speak truth to a world that desperately needs to know that Jesus Christ loves them. Use this again, not as an end, but use this now as a means to go and do wonderful things around this world for Christ, to serve as an ambassador of His. We'll now continue with the program, and it will proceed unannounced until the time of the introduction of our speaker.
Jesus once told a story about a sower and some seeds. The sower threw his seeds on a variety of surfaces and soils. As told in Mark chapter 4, some seed fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil. Other seed fell among thorns, which grew up and choked the plants, so they did not bear grain. Still other seeds fell on good soil, and it's those seeds that are fruitful and are able to produce a crop for generations. As an avid gardener and a teacher who works in a farming community, I understand that planting seeds in the right type of soil and providing the right amount of nutrients is crucial in generating a fruitful plant. If I plant just a few seeds and do not nurture them, my hope for a bountiful harvest is all but lost. As followers of Christ, Jesus calls us to be sowers, to plant and nurture seeds. At some point in each of our lives, a seed was planted in us, one which grew and produced fruits of forgiveness, compassion, grace, faithfulness, and love. These fruits are evident that Jesus Christ is at work within us. And Philippians chapter 1, verse 6 says, "He who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion." But our work isn't done yet. We are now the sowers that must go out into the world and plant these seeds in others, working alongside Christ to heal creation. Our experiences at Spring Arbor University have prepared us to be sowers that produce a fruitful crop for Christ Jesus. Our time here, relationships built, knowledge learned, and faith matured, has prepared us for traveling beyond the borders of this campus to plant seeds throughout the world. We know the love and freedom of Christ, but there are still others who need that seed planted and nourished within them. Whatever it be, whether it be family, friends, children, co-workers, neighbors, acquaintances, or strangers, we must have the courage to sow and nourish the word of God in others. Meister Eckhart once said, "The seed of God grows into God," so we must be willing to go and plant God's seeds. But seeds grow slow. It takes time and patience. It takes commitment. As graduates of Spring Arbor University, I challenge all of us to take the knowledge God has granted us and participate in being sowers of Jesus. Commit yourselves to do this good work, sacrificing of yourselves to nurture the seeds you plant. Remember those that planted and nourished seeds in you. Reflect on how your experiences and education at Spring Arbor University have produced a fruitful harvest in you, one that glorifies Jesus Christ. And as we now continue our journey after this day, remember that He who began a good work in you wants to continue to use you to spread this love and forgiveness of Jesus Christ to heal and redeem this world. So be courageous, be bold, be patient, and keep sowing. Congratulations, Spring Arbor graduates, and many blessings for your future. Thank you.
There's a passage of scripture in Ezekiel that says, wherever the river flows, everything will live. And it's my prayer for you graduates that that has been your experience at Spring Arbor University. That's a metaphor for the river of God. And my prayer for you is that you've experienced the river God, and that has refined you and fed you through a season that was not always easy, that was a lot of hard work. And my prayer is that you will find yourselves refined by that river God. Rough and grainy still. reconcile this river's chill. But when I close my eyes and feel you rushing by, I know that time brings change, and change. Just a little smoother in your hair. Sometimes raging wild, sometimes swollen high. Never have I known this river dry. Stay and feel the sharpest edges washed away. But when I close my eyes and feel you rushing by, I know that time brings change, and change
Heidi, thank you for your words, and Katie, thank you for such a beautiful song. To introduce our speaker today, Quentin J. Schultz is a sought-after speaker. He's an award-winning author, a highly respected news media source, a beloved teacher, and a trusted mentor. His mentees hold key posts in media, government, corporations, and religious organizations. He's a professor of communication at Calvin College, where he holds the distinguished Arthur H. de Kreuter Chair of Faith and Communications. He's been interviewed by more than 100 television and print media outlets, including the Wall Street Journal, Newsweek, the New York Times, CBS, NBC, NPR, and any other news source you can think of. He's a native of Chicago, Illinois, and earned a PhD in communication from the University of Illinois. His scholarly publications have appeared in several dozen journals and numerous books. He serves on the editorial boards of leading communication journals. He's written over 100 articles for general interest publications, including newspapers, magazines, and online periodicals. He's produced several video series on the relationship between faith and communication. Dr. Schultz's 15 books include Resume 101, an essential guide to public speaking, and habits of the high-tech heart living virtuously in the information age. And he's received 4 national book awards for those books. He's spoken at many academic conferences, a wide array of trade shows, over 60 colleges and universities, numerous civic events, and on Capitol Hill. He's consulted for several dozen organizations on communication-related matters. He's a co-founder of the web-based Gospel Communications Network, including the Bible Gateway. He serves on the board for Baker Publishing, one of the largest religious book publishing companies in the world, and he founded Eden Ridge Press. Dr. Schultz is a former president of the Religious Speech Communication Association, in which 2004 named him the Scholar of the Year. He's taught courses for such schools as Regent University, Drake University, Calvin Seminary, Asbury Theological Seminary, and most recently Spring Arbor University, which awarded him the position of Distinguished University Professor. So please join me in welcoming our 2013 commencement speaker, Dr. Quentin Schultz.
Wow. Is there any time left for the commencement address? I'm embarrassed by all of that. So let's just forget about all of that. Talk about me, and let's talk about you, and let's talk about Spring Arbor. Let's talk about the fact that I am honored to be here because of what you all mean to each other, to the work of the graduates, and to the work of the kingdom of God. It honors me to be here, period. Thank you for all of the warmth and friendship from my friends at Spring Arbor. Oh, for 1,000 days that we could have like this one. You came in the morning with the storm, and you will leave with the sunshine. This is the way every day, every life should be. We move through storms, we move through darkness, and we see light on the end, and that light brings us to laughter, to laughter. You'll be challenged in many ways by many people with what to do with a degree. And I'm going to challenge you to one thing, and that is to laugh. I'm going to call you to laughter, because laughter is one of the best things for followers of Jesus Christ to do, to laugh. Oh, for 1,000 days in our lives, it would be filled with deep laughter, so deep that the laughter would turn to tears. And I hope some of you here today, by the end of the day, with the graduates, hand in hand, arm in arm, hugging, laughing together, the tears will flow, the tears that come with laughter and joy. I have 2 adult children. When my son was about 5, he and I were out for a walk. I learned early on that if you want to communicate with someone, don't set up an agenda, don't make it formal, just do something together, and the communication will come, and it will generally be better than anything you can force. So my 5-year-old son and I would go for walks. Whatever came up, we would talk about. If nothing came up, that was okay too. Great bonding time. And one day we're walking down the sidewalk just a few doors down from our house, and being in a professorial stupor, not paying attention to the sidewalk, my toes hit a particular crack, my shoe got stuck, and I flew over face forward right next to my young son. And it's one of those cases where it happens so fast, and you know something bad's gonna result, but you can't do anything about it, it's just happening. And as I was headed down to the ground, for some reason, I put my hands down, my toe was freed, I managed to flip around, do a somersault, and land standing back up again. And I was wiggling around a little bit like this, and my son looks over at me and says, "Dad, Dad, that's great, do it again." I said, "Steve, listen, I want to do it again. What had happened if I hadn't managed to catch myself and flip over? What if I had gone straight down with my nose, my big nose, right on that sidewalk, blood coming down from my face? I was a little bit angry that he was laughing at me. And suddenly his smile evaporated, and he became kind of fearful about that. I said, "Steve, you're right. You're right. I'm wrong. I made it through. I tripped up, but I'm standing up again." And you should have said, "Do it again. If I could, I would." It was a matter of grace. And in fact, all deep laughter, the kind of laughter that comes from deep inside us, our guts out, this deep laughter, the best laughter in the world, is based on a kind of joy and delight that comes because things are right. Things have worked out for good. There's been grace. Laughter is a gift that comes because of grace. God is a God who endows us with laughter in the midst of our fallen lives and all of our problems and difficulties when things work out. I look out over the graduates down here. If we could bottle all of the times that they went through difficulty of one kind or another in their lives, the things that they had to overcome in order to get where they are today, we could take all of those and just hold them up together and look at them and bottle it. I don't know, do something. How could we imagine it? Create a word map, an image, a painting, something. And we could all look at that. It would be huge what's been overcome. Huge. And here they are today. We all, every one of us, we're all parables. We're living parables. Our lives reflect the reality of the gospel, the reality of the fallenness and brokenness of the world and our imperfections, our lack of holiness. And yet our lives also show God's grace as he comes along and picks us off for salvation, as he calls us to various things, as he gives us loved ones, as he incorporates us into educational communities like this to be able to get degrees supported by other people. The history of Spring Arbor University is the history of God's grace, even God's laughter, forming out of this countryside, partly in the middle of nowhere in Michigan, an incredible community of learners who are all over the world. It's laughable in the best sense. How could God do this, and how could it go on? And today I think about the different centers that you came from, where you studied together in different groups, and God was present there, seeing you along. Our lives are parables. And in these parables are many reasons for laughter, deep laughter. I'm thinking of Ephesians 2, the Apostle Paul's letter, went at least to the church in Ephesus, perhaps to other churches as well. That second chapter, first 9 verses, Paul lays out the gospel, and he says, don't boast about this. All the good stuff that happens, especially salvation, God was there first making it happen. And then in the last verse, verse 10 in Ephesians 2, Paul says, for we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works that he prepared in advance for us to do. That, my friends, is the imagery right there. That's the imagery of God, the master artist. We are God's workmanship or craftsmanship, or literally interpreted as God's poetry, God's art. And God's like, imagine this as a symphony. He's the head of the symphony, the director. He's written the score. Part of that score is the word of God itself. And he's playing along with us, and we take our seats in faithfulness. And God is making this incredible music, all of us together. All of us together, part of it, with the good works prepared for us to walk into them. So if you look back, graduates and family, as faculty, all of the people who keep up this building, the people who maintain the building, the people in campus security, everybody who's contributed to the fact that these graduates could be here today are part of that symphony that God has called together of good works to make it happen. It's an incredible vision. It's a laughable vision. Today, graduating, laugh about this. Laugh about all the things you've been through, all the people that have been through it with you, and especially with God through the Holy Spirit walking by your side, making things happen. The first day of class with my students, I say a few things just to set the framework, and one thing I say is that I will never evaluate you as a human being, as a follower of Jesus Christ, based on your academic performance in my class. Some of you are stinkers and you should have worked harder. Some of you are perfectionists and you shouldn't have worked so hard. Some of you have guilt about it. Forget it. It's the good works that came about anyway. In retrospect, God was there making things happen. What's important now is to give thanks to God for what you have achieved as part of this community, this symphony that God is directing. To enjoy it, to celebrate, to laugh about it. And then to move forward filled with the joy and the delight that comes with knowing that God has been with you and will be with you. The same son that I went for that walk with many years ago, 4 years ago, was married in Charleston, South Carolina. The night before the wedding, he and I were in his hotel room, and he said to me, "Dad, let's go out for a walk." And we went through downtown Charleston about 10 p.m. Most of it was shut down. It was Halloween. College students running around in costumes and all from the college there. It was quite funny. And we're walking along, and my son says to me, "Dad, how did you feel the night before you were married?" I said, "Son, scared out of my mind. I didn't know if I could do it. I didn't have good role models from my parents. Bless their souls, but they really didn't know how to parent. They didn't have good role models either. It was a struggle. And I didn't know if I could do it. Could I be a father? Could I be a husband? I just didn't know. God has been good." My son turned to me and he said, "Dad, I don't feel the same way. You and Mom have been the kind of role models through God's grace that I'm going into this marriage feeling really good, that we'll make it happen. God was there for you. God will be there for us in great ways." Can you imagine how I felt as a father that night? Now here's the thing, gang. Our Father in heaven, right now, is looking down upon us, listening, minding what's in your hearts and all, and saying to you, "You made some problems. You stumbled. You're worried about things you might wanted to do differently. Do it again. Do it again. Move forward in life filled with the joy that comes knowing that I have been with you this far. Because we are all, each one of us, parables. We're God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works that he prepared in advance for us to do. Step into those good works, my friends. They're out there. Oh, for 1,000 days in each of our lives, like this one, filled with joy and filled with laughter. Laugh today to the point of tears, and God will be there with you. Thank you."
Thank you, Dr. Schultz, for the reminder to take joy in life. And even in the midst of pain, understand that Christ has come and he's overcome. He's taken the trouble, he's taken the hardship, and he's given us perspective in the midst of it. And in that, we can find joy and peace and laughter. So thank you. At this point in time, I'd like to invite Kimberly Rupert, Provost and Chief Academic Officer, to join me and assist in the presentation of our graduates.
President Ellis. President Ellis, on behalf of the faculty, it is my pleasure and honor to present these students who qualify for graduation with their respective degrees. The faculty and the Board of Trustees have approved that each of these students, upon verification of the completion of all requirements, be awarded the appropriate academic degree. Will all of the candidates for graduation please stand?
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Spring Arbor University and under the laws of this great state of Michigan, I confer upon you the appropriate degree with all the rights, privileges, and obligations pertaining thereto.
Okay. We will now present individually the members of the graduating class to receive their respective degrees. Specific honors earned by each student will be read aloud and are listed in the graduation program. The gold cords and stoles graduates are wearing signify those who have earned academic honors. Graduates, please be seated. Faculty marshals will lead you row by row to the platform. Audience, as the graduates' names are read for presentation of degrees, we will have several opportunities for you to acknowledge them. First, as you applaud for your special graduate, we ask that we keep your celebration brief to allow the name of the next graduate to be heard when it is announced. After the names of graduates from each site or major have been read, we will pause and ask you to join in applause for all of the graduates from that location or program. Our Associate Provost Rod Stewart will be reading the names of the graduates, and the deans will be assisting as the program proceeds.
We will begin today's names in reading those that have earned their degrees with those with a master's degree and who have received the traditional master's hood. Graduating today from the School of Arts and Sciences with a Master of Arts in Communication, Sarah P. Merrill. Tracy Perry. Benjamin M. Warman. Graduating now from our School of Education with a Master of Arts in Education, Rebecca S. Acko. Kim Nolan Brown. Aaron M. Grenier. Andrea B. Ortel. Christy E. Reagan. Sarah E. Ryko. Heidi C. Rhodes. From our Ganey School of Business, with a Master of Business Administration, Ashley M. Arquette. Jessica J. Bridges. Amy L. Clark. Gregory F. Crump. Bradley C. Dalton. Alex M. Gast. Lacey A. George. Michael D. Hendershot. Elizabeth A. Knobloch. Daniel L. Murphy. Bobby Nasser. Adam M. Puckett. Ryan Rice. Edward W. St. John, Jr. Troy M. Trahan. graduating from the School of Graduate and Professional Studies with a Master of Arts in Counseling, Talana S. Murphy. Graduating with a Master of Arts in Family Studies, Mary J. Campbell. Leanne M. Clement. Elizabeth C. Foley. Desiree T. Hughes. Jessica S. Pack. William D. Potter. LaShonda D. Walker. Ramisha T. Wilmer. Maggie A. Young. As we go to another group of masters, let's give those groups a round of applause. Graduating with a Master of Science in Management, Michael P. Baker. Jeremy Bolenbaugh. Amanda R. Brown. Robin R. Brubaker. Joseph M. Eckert. Tamitha L. Fain. Lisa M. Flynn. Brian S. Guadagnini. Dana L. Harrison. Venzel M. Hill. Danielle M. Hilliker. Makia D. Jackson. Cheryl L. Jensen. Jamie L. Konitsky. Daniel J. Lafier. Lindsay D. Lamontagne. Ivory L. Qualls. Aaron J. Sanford. Sandra L. Walker. Timothy C. Walls. Scott B. Williams. Let's now offer our congratulations to those from the School of Graduate and Professional Studies. Now graduating with a Master of Science in Nursing, Stephen M. Allen, Jr. Chandra L. Kohli. Ruth A. Freebury. Margaret M. Hurst. Donna M. Ismailoglu. Carrie J. McAvoy. Jennifer A. Otmanowski. Stacy A. Palmer. Stacy L. Sutton. Let's now give a round of applause for all of our master's degree recipients. We now turn to those receiving a bachelor's degree. With a Bachelor of Arts degree from the School of Arts and Sciences from the Department of Art with an art major, Jesse L. Brandel. Jennifer M. St. Charles. With a biology major, Cassandra L. Dunbar, magna cum laude, double major in Spanish. With a chemistry major, Jin H. No. With an individualized major in biology and chemistry, Douglas H. Meniere. From the Department of Communication and Media, with an advertising and public relations major, Abby L. Dyer, magna cum laude. With a broadcasting major, Cheyenne Rochelle Martinez Trevino. With a drama major, Paul L. McKinley, cum laude and an E.P. Hart Honors Scholar. With an individualized major, Sydney A. Williams. From the Department of Health, Human Performance and Recreation, with a Health and Exercise Science major, Godwin K. Adai. Taylor S. Lang. With a Recreation and Leisure Management major, Samuel G. Lund, magna cum laude. Audra L. Norris. From the Department of History, Geography, and Politics, with a history major, Anna R. Townley. With a social studies major, Caitlin M. Myers, cum laude. Beth A. Ray. From the Department of Psychology, with a psychology major, Shanna M. Crouch, magna cum laude. Justin J. Sadler. from the Department of Sociology with a criminal studies major, Joseph M. Coe. With a global studies major, Eric S. Manzella, cum laude. Abigail J. Reitz. With a sociology major, Amy L. Winters. From the Department of Social Work, with a social work major, Jesslyn E. Agee. Ariel M. Kunz. Sarah I. Dunsmore. Christine M. Mapes. From the Department of Theology with a Children Ministry major, Kyle S. Glasser. With an individualized major, Elizabeth K. Wood. From the Department of World Languages with a Spanish major, Krathman G. Stevens, Sr. From the Ganey School of Business, Department of Business with a Business Administration major, Robert J. Cunningham. Jeremy M. Shankle. With an individualized major, Margaret E. Barley. With an international business major, Thomas M. Hess, cum laude. From the School of Education, Early Childhood Education, Megan A. Musiklakovich. Emily C. Sutka, summa cum laude. In elementary education, Kristen E. Borup. Jana L. Horton, summa cum laude. Crystal L. Strasser. In special education, Kristen M. Lowe. Jaylee G. Robinson Evans with a double major in world languages. And with an Associate of Arts, Clarissa M. Jordan. Let's now give congratulations to all those that are our campus-based programs for their bachelor's degrees and associates. Now those graduating from the School of Graduate and Professional Studies from our East Region are Jackson Site with a Bachelor of Arts major in FLE, Jody L. Thompson. From our Metro Detroit site, also in FLE, Laura J. Rosau. Yvonne D. Bailey. Mona L. Harris. Marie C. Robinson. Tracy J. Rucker. Tina M. Shelton. Deborah A. Tyler. From our Tabernacle site, FLE, Sydney D. Holmes Davis. Ruth A. Boston Gromer. From our Midwest region, our Flint site in FLE, Jacqueline C. Blair. Joe R. Tyler Jr. Gloria D. Boone. Robin M. Chamberlain. From our Kalamazoo site with a CML major, Amy J. Van Putten. Teresa L. Lewis. Chad M. Campbell. Brooke E. Eagle Pike. Andrew C. Kaiser. From our Lansing site in General Studies, Ernest W. Gaffner. In FLE, Sylvia Arizola. Rochelle N. Brennenstuhl, magna cum laude. Tammy M. Britton. Mark A. Denning. Dawn D. Todd. Nathan S. Yerian. Let's now congratulate those from our Midwest region. From our North region, our Gaylord site, in FLE, Stacy R. Bauer, cum laude. Dracina R. Butchkowski. Michelle K. Holzma, summa cum laude. Shannon B. Smith. Stacy A. Todd. Nicole M. Wary. From our Grand Rapids site in General Studies, Brent L. Norman. From our Traverse City site in FLE, Lori C. Yoder. Casey D. Cornelius Gallimore. Christina L. Fox. Let's now congratulate those from our North region. Graduating now from our East region and our Jackson site with a Bachelor of Science degree, major in business, Raymond P. Putnam, summa cum laude. Teresa A. Walensky. Carl N. Zweifel. In ORM, Anna Marie Lafier. John E. Wilkie, Sr. From our Metro Detroit site in ORM, Wedad K. Matuk, cum laude. Cassandra L. Maho. Clarence Presley II. Denisa A. Terrell. Rebecca D. Walker. Delana D. Wise. Sasha A. Williams. From our Metro Toledo site and business, Jeffrey J. Kaza. Nancy L. Dabney. Susan Y. Noel. Joseph L. Watkins. An ORM, Pamela J. Brewer. Monica Adams. Tracy A. Johnson. Paula J. Reidner. Blanca R. Romero, magna cum laude. Joseph M. Schaefer. Marin E. Kurtz, cum laude. Lori M. Spain. Let's now give our honors, congratulations to that group of students. Graduating now from our Midwest region, our Battle Creek site in ORM, Alexander C. Kahn IV. In ORM, Matthew D. Bierlein. Douglas E. McDonald. Andrea N. Best. From our Kalamazoo site in ORM, Catherine E. Bickle. Nicole A. M. Kiesler. Elaine M. Rawlings. Benjamin R. Aldrich. Stephen T. Earl. Tammy L. Grosser. Mary E. Hannapel. Naomi F. Kudzia. Amanda L. Popuda. Sheila L. Rupert, cum laude. Jeanette L. Stryker. David R. Williams. Justine N. Culliver. Ashley L. Furr, cum laude. Matthew D. Hagenbuck. From our Lansing site in ORM, Joy L. Hazard. Valerie H. Musayak Ara Ube. Laura B. Davenport. Todd W. Butler. Chelsea J. Cummings. Chara L. Grinald, summa cum laude. Heather A. Haddad. Deborah L. Henning, magna cum laude. Kyle A. Hilliker. Catherine A. Martin. Lauren M. Platt. Douglas P. Rezegi. Cindy J. Rue. Stephanie L. Thielen. Let's now graduate those from our Midwest region. Graduating now from our North region, from our Gaylord site in ORM, Kathleen S. Julian. Bradley S. Wybengun. Laura K. Wilcox, summa cum laude. From our Traverse City site in ORM, Gretchen L. Van Ormer. Jeremy L. Kavanaugh. In our online ORM, Ashley M. Olentz. Dorenda A. Foster. Deneen M. Thrasher, cum laude. Mary Hay Wittenberg, magna cum laude. Emily D. Harn, summa cum laude. Phyllis McKay. Let's now honor those from the North region for those programs. Graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Nursing from our East region and our Jackson site with a BSN, Tracy A. Hathaway. From our Metro Toledo site, also with a BSN, Tamara M. Swicegood. From our Midwest region, our Battle Creek site, Christopher R. Cui with a BSN. Marcia C. Fish. Jennifer L. McNutt. Nicole M. Roy. From our Kalamazoo site with a BSN, Christine T. Bradford. Lacey L. Howe. Tammy S. Parsons. Victoria A. Sharp. Kimberly S. Tenney, magna cum laude. From our Lansing site with a BSN, Conception L. Crow. April I. Archer. Joy O. Asamota. Angela M. Bry, cum laude. Susan A. Bryan. Gwen K. Kuhn. Marisa E. McLean, cum laude. Michelle A. Wiseman. Those are more graduates from our Midwest region. Let's honor them. Now from our North region, our Gaylord site and BSN, Amanda M. Hamill. Michelle R. Barber. From our Grand Rapids site of the BSN, Jennifer L. Catalino. Ann M. Kimball. From our Traverse City site with a BSN, Lena L. Hodges. Let's honor those from our North region for BSN. Graduating now with a Bachelor of Social Work from our East region on our Fremont site with a BSW, Cassandra R. Anderson. Sarah L. Castillo. Charlene L. Moulter. Candida M. Knopfs. Kira S. Rodriguez, cum laude. Jennifer B. Sanders. Patrice L. Wetzel, summa cum laude. With a BSW from our Metro Detroit site, Anthony F. Vagian. Abir S. Bazzi. Caitlin R. Buckner. Sabrina R. Levine. Tamara J. Wright. Lisa E. Thompson, cum laude. From our Metro Toledo site with the BSW, Shanice S. Lard. Kimberly S. Martin. Sabrina R. Barnett Jamison. Rudy Flores. Christina J. Markin. Deborah M. Neal. Stephanie S. Petaway. Monica H. Spittler. Leslie A. Strait. Sadie M. Wilson III. From our Troy site with the BSW, Casey A. Sickety DeYoung. John P. Harrison. Camelia O. Hill. Garth A. Leamy. Sarah E. Mitchell. Patricia A. Willis. Those are from our East region. Let's give them a round of applause, please. Now from our Midwest region, our Bay City site with a BSW, Kathleen M. Banke, cum laude. From our Lansing site with a BSW, Duana E. Ben. Adrian L. Boulanger. Kathleen A. Forker. Amanda J. Girding, summa cum laude. Jacqueline E. Heister. Aaron J. Jasper. Anissa P. Kent Johnson. Tyler J. Langani. Teresa A. Moore. Trina L. Simon. Sharon D. Truss. Indira Vazgeek. Alyssa N. Van Vassen. John N. Worthy. Those are our BSW graduates from our Midwest region. Let's give them congratulations. Graduating now from our North region, our Grand Rapids site with a BSW, June M. Bauman. Graduating with an Associate of Science in Business from our Midwest region, our Battle Creek site, Aretha M. Brown Burgess. Alicia Santiago Ganser. From our Flint site with the ASB, Shelley A. Long. Greg Almirani. From our Lansing site with ASB, John L. Farley. Marsha K. Pung. With the ASB from our Kalamazoo site, Jenny L. Marshall. Bridget L. Bowerman.
This is a wonderful day to celebrate, and congratulations again to the class of 2013 for your hard work, for your dedication, for your perseverance. Fantastic job, class. And give them another round of applause. It's fantastic. The graduates, I also know that you could not have done this if you did not have the support, if you did not have the encouragement of both the faculty, but also friends and family and loved ones, children, husbands, wives, parents. If you would stand up, look around, find your loved one and thank them, graduates. We truly are a community of learners. So before a benediction is given by Dan Russell, a chaplain from our East region, I would like to ask the families to wait here until your graduate returns for you after the recessional. So at this time, I ask the audience to stand during the benediction and then to be seated for the recessional, which will immediately follow the prayer. Thank you.
Let's pray together. Dear God, our Heavenly Father, I come to you and through your Son Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, asking your benediction on this graduation, as well as your benediction on the lives of these students. May you be their source of hope, joy, and peace as they trust in you, and may they overflow with confidence as your Holy Spirit empowers them in their careers and further studies. Bless them, Lord, with patience and encouragement as they face the difficulties of life, as well as help them to live in harmony with the difficult people in their life, as is fitting for followers of Christ Jesus. O Lord, keep them from all harm and watch over them in a dangerous world, giving them strength when they are weak, peace when they are troubled. May they pray like Jabez in the Old Testament by asking you to bless them indeed, enlarge their territory, that your hand would be with them, and that you would keep them from all evil, that they would cause no pain. May you, Heavenly Father, smile on them, be gracious to them, and show your favor to them. And may the grace and love of your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of your Holy Spirit be with them all now and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.